And welcome to the next lesson in the series on AWS Fundamentals. So today I'm going to be teaching you about a service called AWS Elastic Beanstalk. Now, with the AWS Elastic Beanstalk service, we will be able to deploy our web application with this service. So let's go ahead and look for it. So it will be called Elastic Beanstalk. Okay, so we can just bookmark this here and give that a click. Okay, so let's go to it. Okay, and we can see here the homepage that we are greeted with here. So basically, with the service, like I mentioned, we can use it for deploying and scaling web applications and services developed with Java, .NET, PHP, Node.js, Python, Ruby, Go. And as you can see, there are so many other services, and we can also utilize Docker with it as well. Okay, so just bear in note the pricing here. So basically, when you are creating an Elastic Beanstalk environment, you do not pay for the environment you create, but instead the resources that are created with it, such as the EC2 instances that you run, the Amazon S3 buckets, which pretty much cost next to nothing, and of course, if you're utilizing a load balancer. So your main costs here would really be your EC2 instances and your load balancer if you utilize that. Okay, so that is really the bulk of your pricing here. S3 buckets won't cost you, will barely cost you anything. And when it comes to your database, if you're using the free tier, you've got a lot of hours on it, so that will also cost you next to nothing. Unless you run over it, of course. So just bear in mind the pricing there. Okay, so to get started with Elastic Beanstalk, you can go ahead and say create application. You can just name your application here. Under the application tags, you do not need to add anything here. Now, platform is very important, so you can choose a platform. As you can see, we have Docker, Go, Java, PHP, Python, so many languages. So I'm going to go with Python, and it's best to go for the most recent version of Python here, so it's 3.8. Now, I know what some of you are wondering. Okay, so I'm using Python 3.9. Will this work? Okay, that is a good question. So basically, when it comes to utilizing Elastic Beanstalk, it's kind of a trial and error thing. So you'll have to test this out thoroughly with your application. And it's not always fully dependent on the Python version as you'd expect. A big part of this and the issues come from the dependencies and packages you use. Okay, so from experience, I'm using the latest version of Python 3.9, I believe 3.9.13. Okay, and I have deployed to Elastic Beanstalk, no problems whatsoever. The real concern is really with your packages, okay? Now, there will be a point, obviously, when Elastic Beanstalk has to, you know, sort themselves out and improve this version here of Python. But do bear in mind, it's not always to say you'll need to test this and make sure. Okay, this is coming from if you're someone that develops Python applications, Django, whatever. This is specifically for you. In terms of the other languages, I'm sure the same sort of concept goes out. You're going to have to really test and see, okay? It's not for sure. You need to check for yourself and figure it out. And in most of the cases, like I said, it's got to do with your dependencies here. So don't just rule out Elastic Beanstalk just out yet until you test it, because trust me, it is actually a very simple way to deploying your web applications. So just hear my point on this, very important. Okay, so we can choose the platform version here, that's fine. Now, we can go ahead and start with a sample application. This is what I'm going to do, so I can just show you a little bit about Elastic Beanstalk. Or you can upload your code here. So you would have your version, you can upload the local file, or upload your source code to Amazon S3, and you would just go ahead and pull it out from the S3 URL. Okay, but this isn't the optimal way of uploading and deploying to Beanstalk. The best way is to upload it with the AWS CLI. So with the AWS command line interface and uploading it that way. That is the best way to doing it. This way is okay, but it can be a bit confusing. So I would suggest using the AWS CLI for this purpose. I believe there are lots of references to how to do this, okay, depending on the code that you're using and the programming language. So it's really a simple process. Okay. Under application code tags, you don't need to do anything there, so we can leave that blank. So what we're going to do is we're simply going to choose a sample application instead, and I'm just going to show you just a general way of how this whole process works. So you can choose sample application, and it's going to create a sample Python application for us, which will probably be either based on Flask or Django. So let's create the application. Okay, so we're just going to configure settings now. And what's going to happen is it's going to create an application, and then it's going to create sort of like a virtual environment or environment for your application, which is what we're seeing now, basically. So it's going to create the application and the environment for us. Okay, so this can take a few minutes. This can take a while, so maybe 10 to 15 minutes, actually. So what I'm going to do is pause the video, and then I'm going to just refresh the page, and you'll see quite a difference here. Okay, so let's just wait for that, and then we'll get straight back to this. So let's go ahead and refresh and see if it's still busy. Okay, so it has been a few minutes already, so let's see what's going on. And there we go. So everything seems to be working fine. Make sure that the health is okay and that the platform is running as it should. Perfect. Okay, so if we scroll down, we can see a list of events. So basically what was happening here is when we were deploying our application, well, when we were creating it and it AWS Elastic Beanstalk deployed it for us, we can see a few events here. So for example, it generated its own proc file. So for those of you that have deployed with Heroku before, you'll recognize that proc file name here. Okay, it obviously created an application for us and deployed it. And we can go and actually select show all, so we can see greater detail here. So we can scroll down and we can see it created an auto scaling group for us. Yeah, of course, it created EC2 instances, a load balancer as well, security groups, target groups, and all of that. So we can see all the events that it has done. So this is why this makes it perfect for developers. Okay, so it follows sort of a developer deployment centric sort of view, you could say. So in a sense that you do not need to worry about your infrastructure. You don't need to actually go ahead and, for example, you know, worry about the infrastructure and worry about everything like that. You can literally just go straight in and you can deploy your application. Usually there are some things that you need to configure and set up. Of course, there always is, but it is not as complicated as, you know, managing the infrastructure yourselves, where you would need to understand how to manage EC2 instances, auto-scaling groups, load balancers, security groups, for example, your RDS database, S3 buckets, and all of that. Now, with your S3 buckets, okay, it's very easy to do it manually with the infrastructure. But if you were to use it with Elastic Beanstalk, you can just head over to your configuration setting here on the left. And you can see everything that you have here, such as your capacity, your load balancer, security groups, and you can actually edit these properties here, such as instances. You can edit things such as CloudWatch monitoring, the root volume, your security groups, and so on. What you can also do is, like I was about to mention earlier, you can also configure your Amazon S3 buckets here as well, okay, if you would like to do that as well. You can actually go ahead and configure it. So for example, if you scroll down, you can see, for instance, with the database, so you can manually go to, say, edit, and you can actually go ahead and configure and add your database here. Okay, so this just shows that Elastic Beanstalk is a very good way if you don't want to manage any infrastructure. It's the best way to go. And this is why it's seen as something called platform as a service. Okay, so the main focus is on deployment. Now, a great thing that we can do now is we can actually open our application here with the following link that it gives us to our sample application. And we can just see this page here that says, congratulations, your first AWS Elastic Beanstalk application, Python application is now running on the AWS cloud with Elastic Beanstalk on the Python platform. So this is great. So what you can actually do further is, since you have a load balancer, you can go to your load balancer, and what you can do is you can set an alias. You can create an alias record in Route 53 so that you change this domain, okay, to your own domain name with your HTTPS certificate with Amazon Certificate Manager. Okay, so you can also manage it that way as well. Okay, so that's it. I won't go into further detail, but just know if you don't want to build and worry about infrastructure on AWS, Elastic Beanstalk is the way to go. You can configure your S3 buckets, you can configure your database, and you don't need to worry about creating auto-scaling groups, load balancers, EC2 instances. It's all done for you. And like I said, there is some pricing here, okay, and it can be costly depending on how much you use and what services you need and so on. But this is a great alternative if you don't want to worry about handling infrastructure. Okay, so I'm just going to show you now how you would delete this. So you would just go to Actions, and you would say Terminate Environment. Go here, terminate your environment. So don't worry, it's going to delete all of the resources at once, okay, which can take a while. This can usually take also 5 to 10 minutes. So what I'm going to do is pause the video, and then we will need to delete then the application, and then we will be done with the cleanup for this environment and application that we have created. So let's just wait for that. All right. So after some time, we should be able to see this page. So don't worry if it's still taking time for you. It does take a while. So now we can just see the application. So we can delete the application itself by clicking here. Go to action, say delete application. Just retype your application name in, or you can just like me be lazy and just copy and paste it. Okay, so let's just wait for that. And there we go. So we should now see the Amazon Elastic Beanstalk page after we are done. So that's it on AWS Elastic Beanstalk, or Amazon Elastic Beanstalk as the correct name. So that's it. And I hope I gave you some insight into this as to another deployment method that you can utilize if you want to deploy your web application, apparently in minutes. So that's it, guys. Thank you.